takeover. Last mission, last mission. Final boss mode. But before we do get up here, we do have a preview for one fight that's coming up next Saturday. You know, you think, like, after such a big boxing weekend, you know, what can you, you know, everyone's pretty much waiting for Lomachenko and Lopez, pretty much. That's, like, the next big fight going on. But, you know, there are some fights that are, you know, coming up, but, you know, there's one, you know, one pretty significant fight for Top Rank. You know, we got Ivan Baranchuk, you know, and we got Jose Cepeda. Now, this fight was supposed to be part of Top Rank Summer Series.
COVID,
and unfortunately got canceled. It was probably the best fight on that, you know, on that full series that they announced. So it was a disappointment, because it was one of the few fights that I was like, okay, this is like a fight of the year on paper, you know. So I mean, it took a while for them, you know, to get that rescheduled, but they did, and you know, they got the home card. And you know, Baranchuk, you know, has been low key. I mean, Loki's been part of the 140 renaissance. I mean, I know he had a fight of the year like on Showbox a couple years ago. I remember, LB, you were raving about that fight. I think I missed that fight. It had something going on, but you were raving about it.
Damn, who he fought again for me to say all that? I'm trying to remember.
It was Abel Ramos. There we go.
Oh, fuck. I'm going to have to rewatch that. Yeah, that fight was good.
Yeah. Baranchuk has been putting up good fights, like fight after fight lately. So, yeah. I mean, definitely part of the 140, you know, renaissance. You are correct.
Yeah, he definitely,
cause
he definitely.
Because I can't think of a Baranchuk fight that I left disappointed.
Yeah, no, and then dude, I mean, and obviously dude entered the World Boxing Super Series, and he won. I mean, he was briefly, you know, a super lightweight champion. He won it in the first round, and then he would lose his belt to Josh Taylor in the next.
In another good fight.
Yeah, hell of a fight.
Yeah, both fights were actually pretty good. The one we won his belt was, you know, it was pretty brutal. Like, he closed dude's eye, like, completely.
Oh, honestly, honestly, now that I think about it, I feel like, in my opinion, for me personally, I feel like Baranchuk helped legitimize Josh Taylor in my eyes.
He did. I mean, it helped that he was undefeated, too. So, you know.
Honestly, that was the fight that made me pick Josh Taylor over Regis Progre.
Yeah, because Baranchuk is a big guy for 140. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I'm surprised he's still at 140. Because that motherfucker is big for 140.
Yeah, he is. You know.
Yeah.
And then he needs to move
a fridge or some shit.
And you know, Baranchuk, you know, he definitely, you know, he rebounded in his last fight today against Gabriel Bracero, knocking him out in four rounds. You know, so like. And I know he has some issues before with the promoters, but I feel like now I think Top Rank signed them, and it's like, okay, you know, we're gonna make another run for, you know, for another title against Jose Cepeda. You know, Jose Cepeda, of course, he got put on the map because he gave Jose Ramirez all kinds of hell. Personally, I don't remember if I thought he beat him or not, but Ramirez in no way looked like he was, you know, he didn't look like a winner after that fight. That's for damn sure. You know, and he fought up by, you know, by beating Jose Pedraza a couple fights after that. So, I mean, dude is talented. I mean, dude is incredibly talented. I mean, his only loss before that, though, was a freak injury. And he probably would have became champion that night, you know, against Terry Flanagan, you know, if he didn't dislocate his shoulder.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. You know, I mean, he would have beaten Flanagan that night, but it's unfortunate. So... Yeah, so Cepeda now, I mean, he's riding a two fight win streak or whatever. So so thoughts, guys, like, you know, who do you think will win this fight, Baranchuk or Cepeda?
This is a close one, man. Honestly, I was thinking about this earlier today. I'm like, damn, we're gonna talk about this one, but I haven't made up in my mind who I think wins. Like, a part of me feels like Baranchuk is gonna win the gut check. Mm-hmm. And if it's a tough fight, he'll pull through because he's been down that route. Mm-hmm. I think Cepeda might be the better boxer. I think he might get the decision if it's a close fight. But I think Baranchuk will beat him. Like,
yeah, because Cepeda is talented. But I know one thing that I found, like, sometimes I think he loses interest in what he's doing. Like, sometimes he'll lose his focus. Like,
yeah, I don't think that's going to be a problem with Baranchuk. Baranchuk will put his ass in.
Yeah. If you lose your focus against this guy, I mean, you deserve whatever happens.
you know. But you know, but Zepeda though can box and can box pretty well. I mean,
yeah, you know, good movement, good jab, you know, decent punch. You know, he has all the tools, but like Baranchuk, like he gets into animal beast mode, man, and he's strong on the inside. He could wrestle with you. He throws the short uppercuts and clubbing hooks and right hands.
Yeah.
And he's not like he's slow either, so he could stay with you, like.
Yeah, that and the stamina too. Like he has good stamina, so it's like.
Yeah, he fights the whole fucking fight. I don't know, man. But part of me just feel like if it's close, they'll give Zepeda the decision. Like I almost feel like they'll push him more.
Yeah, I mean,
agree. I feel like it's gonna be a war of attrition. But I feel like Baranchuk should come out the winner. But I can see them giving it to Zepeda.
Right. I mean, honestly, yeah, I do think Zepeda will have to actually stop Baranchuk. If Zepeda stops Baranchuk, then yeah, give him a goddamn title shot.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't see it, if he was to stop Baranchuk, I'm like, oh my goodness, like Taylor couldn't do that. Didn't Taylor drop him twice?
Yeah, he dropped him twice. Yeah,
you know, and still had a hard fight, like a good fight with dude.
Yeah, you know, so yeah, this will definitely be the highlight of this coming weekend for sure, though.
Yeah, because it kind of tells me like this guy is somebody who should be, you know, headed toward Pedraza or somebody else in the top upper echelon of 140, maybe even getting a title shot.
Yeah, because I know for sure Pedraza really wants to run it back with Zepeda, and because like, I know he's still smarting from that loss because he got his head boxed off in that fight, you know.
Didn't Zepeda fight like couple months, like he fought a couple months ago, so he should be the fresher fighter.
He did.
But
it's not like he was lights out that day either. Like he, you know, he was solid.
Yeah, I mean, he was almost lights out for like first half of the fight. Then afterwards, he started losing his focus a little bit because Castaneda, I think that it couldn't hurt him really. So
that's what I'm saying. That's like because and Baranchuk is coming off like a year layoff, so I could see Baranchuk getting a couple rounds to take it to get him get going. But then I think it'll start getting really good around the fifth, sixth round.
It need to start getting real good before that. Like we don't need a Derevyanchenko thing again.
Yeah.
Like, you know, get it going, you know. I mean, I could understand Derevyanchenko case because, you know, Charlo, that's a big motherfucker, bro. Like,
right.
Who's eager to run in on him? But Baranchuk and Zepeda, nah, bro, you better get at him.
Exactly. So, yeah, no, I'm expecting.
You know, they're thinking about it as a Ramirez rematch, but Pedraza rematch. It's like Zepeda got fights.
Yeah. Has plenty of fights, and you know, Top Rank has enough 140 contenders. You know,
yeah, they're like all bad blood type fights.
Fact.
So like, you can market them shits. You know, Baranchuk, like if I'm Baranchuk, he got to go for that knockout, bro.
Yeah. Him knocking out Zepeda will speak volumes, and it'll definitely put him in a position to, you know, to, well, I mean, it depends. It'll most likely probably be after the unification, or if, you know, belts start getting stripped. Who knows? Because then, Bob is not, you know, in the mood for mandatories anymore.
Yeah. Although the one thing, sorry, go ahead, Pat, and I'll say what
I was going to say.
The only thing that I did remember, I'm like, wait a minute, I wonder if this is going to fuck with this card, is the fact that Showtime is actually going to be like replaying the fucking Charlo pay-per-view fight on Showtime. So I wonder if that's going to fuck with this fight.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's some dirty shame. Cause
I mean,
yeah.
I don't want the same meal twice.
Yeah,
but some motherfuckers missed the first meal, so they're trying to get the second serve.
Yeah, and of course, that's true. And on top of that, the Zepeda Baranchuk fight is on ESPN Plus, I think.
I fucking hate this ESPN Plus piece of shit. Just put it on ESPN. God.
Well, they've been funny about that because I remember last year I was complaining like, man, they're not putting nothing on ESPN Plus, but they're putting everything under the sun on ESPN Plus.
It's like, but no rhyme or reason. Like, yeah. Honestly, this is a fight that should be on ESPN. Like,
They're so like, there's no like logic to when they put something on ESPN and ESPN Plus. I feel like fights that should be on ESPN Plus to get played on regular ESPN, and then when it should be ESPN, it's on Plus.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because like the fights that are significant have you know face value, you know name recognition. Like this fight, you know, is you're talking about two top 10 guys at 140 going, you know, facing each other. Really, like. I think that's a fair assessment, right?
Yeah.
So whenever you get a meaningful fight, like, because any fight that's in the top 10, top 15 is meaningful. Because somebody has to go up, somebody got to go down. It is what it is. So you want to, you know, put that on the biggest platform available. But when you say, you know what, let's put it on the app.
Yeah.
Like, word? Really? Like, you know.
Yeah, like,
yeah, I wish some boxing promoter would just come along and, you know, just, you know, put interesting, exciting, you know, good fights on regular TV, you know, but yeah, I don't think that's ever happening.
Well, I mean, ESPN Plus, I don't mind the app, but I'm just like, you know, if you know, I always thought that there would be, you know, the big fights would be on ESPN Plus, where you actually have to pay for, you know, like the $6, you know, sort of like the DAZN thing, and then regular fights could be on regular ESPN. But like I said, they don't know. I don't think they know what they want to do with ESPN Plus.
They put the names in a hat, shake it up, and you know they take it out, and they're like, okay, these will be on ESPN Plus, and this will go on ESPN.
Yeah, the fight between Joe Smith and Eddie Alvarez, that should have been on regular ESPN. Yeah, I mean that's probably one.
Yeah, that's a significant fight, meaningful matchup, name, value, recognition.
Yeah,
it checked off on everything.
Yeah, and even with, I mean, it was a good fight and a score, and there was a brutal stoppage. Like that could have been something that could have been on regular TV, you know. So,
but instead, these niggas said, "You know what? Let's put it on an app." Hold on, PP fell off.
Oh, my bad. Okay, there we go.
So, it's like, it's no rhyme or reason, no logic. It's just, you know, it's like murder ball. Like, niggas just throw the ball up in the air and you tackle whoever get it. You know, if the ESPN shirts tackle him, then it's on ESPN. If ESPN Plus, you know, tackle him, then, you know, it's on ESPN Plus. I mean, the end.
Be feeling like I'm at the casino. Black or red? It's going to land on black? It's going to land on red? It's going to land on green?
ESPN Plus it is. Hold on, it's two old niggas. ESPN Classic.
Oh man,
it's a good. Hold on, this fight Saturday, right? Or Friday?
Saturday.
At what time?
Let's see. The main event probably doesn't start till like 10, but I mean the whole, you know, because you know Top Rank has
it start at 8 o'clock.
It starts at 7:30, like the whole card. Yeah, start to
set up. One of these marathon Top Rank cards where a bunch of, you know, career mode knockouts, 6 rounders, 4 rounders.
Something like that.
I mean, sometimes I don't be in the mood for that, man. I just want to see, like, the good fight or the significant fight, you know. Give me the 8 and 10 rounders.
I mean, they got Gabriel Flores in the co-main. You know, and they got, you know, against Ryan Koseski. I mean, that's a dude that lives around my area. You know, he used to fight on Friday Night Fights all the time. You know, so I mean,
okay, I guess that's a little decent, you know.
And then and then even more interesting, they have that Italian heavyweight that they have there, that Guido Vianello, and he's facing that dude, that Nigerian dude. That I was telling that was like Yetuwa Abiabuchi for that summer, you know, that Nigerian cat that went to war with that Samoan cat on ESPN. The one I said, like, it was really throwing. Yeah, so he's facing.
But that's the one I think he was getting gassed, or that's another fight.
No, that's him. That's him.
That's him. Oh, okay. Yeah. So they gave him some time to recover. Okay, so, so we might have a decent night. Okay, I mean, I'm gonna watch that. I ain't trying to replay the Charlo card or none of that.
I'm good with the Charlo card. I'm like, I mean, they were good fights, but I don't feel the need to watch them again.
Yeah.
So
the only fight from that whole card I think is worth watching is, well, the first card actually, but
yeah.
I don't think I'm gonna watch the. Rosario and Jermell Charlo again, or the fight from that card, but I could see myself rewatching the first three fights, definitely.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, the Tiger Ripple Cup spamming and, you know, the Margarito impression of, you know, defense be damned.
Yeah.
And then, you know, and, you know, Jamal Charlo landing, you know, the kitchen sink on some Madonna Stevenson shit repeatedly. So, I mean, hey, I fucks with those fights.
Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, and then, I mean, PBC has the card, but, I mean, on FS1, but... Unless you actually like watching PBC prospects, and I mean, most likely I'll probably will catch that too. But then, like, I mean, unless either, well, actually, funny thing is, most PBC fanboys don't watch FS1, the FS1 cards for some reason. It's kind of odd, you know. But I mean, PBC has an offering, and who knows, you may actually get some excitement there. But it's
I
not
think people forgetting about them cards, and you know.
Yeah. I mean, PBC already represented, anyways, last weekend. And actually, I mean. The Showtime card's gonna outshine that one too, which is kind of stupid. Like, I mean, you know, you're gonna outshine your PBC card. You're looking for your prospects.
Because I think what happens is PBC tries to throw all the prospects on one card, when sometimes you need to, like, do how Top Rank does, kind of integrate them with the bigger cards.
Right. You know.
So, you know, people get more familiar with them. You know.
It's either that or more. Or move it to a different day, like Friday or something, or even Sunday.
Yeah, like even a Friday would be better, because then it's like, all right, Friday night boxing. But a Wednesday, it's like, nigga.
Well, I mean, this one's on Saturday. Like, this FS1 card, it's like a quadruple header of prospects. That's going to get...
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I mean, Top Rank got the card.
Yeah.
like, I ain't going to, you know... I'm not gonna watch a replay, and I'm not gonna watch, you know, shit that ain't happened yet.
Yeah, unless of course, you know, the prospects. Unless one gets into like a fight of the year kind of thing, then we have to watch it just to make
and
sure.
And then I'll go back and watch it or some shit. But that's the thing, man. It's like once you get older and you got more shit to do in life, more responsibilities, you know, bigger dreams, bigger shit you're doing. You know, you don't see every fucking boxing match like you used to. Like, you don't hunt them down and be like, oh, I gotta see this, no matter what the fight looked like. Oh, P came off again.
Yeah, no, I see he hasn't come back on yet.
Yeah, so, you just don't, you know, if you don't hear anything interesting about the fight or whatever, you know, you just don't be compelled to fucking go back and see him sometimes. Yeah. Whereas, you know, when I was younger, it's like, I'm trying to see everything. I'm trying to absorb everything, the knowledge, boxing, this, that, you know. But when you get older, you know, the fire kind of leaves. You're not necessarily jaded. You just got more shit to do. So seeing a card full of prospects and going back to make sure I see that. And, you know, you already got other boxing shows during the week. You know, the bigger fights are going to take precedence. So.
Right. Unless you legitimately don't have shit to do, then, you know, I mean, yeah. I know I'm going to be gone. I'm going
to
be gone.
But it's ring gang. I always got shit to do.
Yeah. Fact. So, you know, life is always busy, you know, but don't get twisted up. Boxing, you know, like I said, we will read about it. There's no question about it. And like I said, if it's a good fight, we will watch the highlights, because, you know, this is 2020 now. We get highlights on YouTube. It's not like the old days where we'd have to wait until the next day, you know, for HBO or Showtime to actually show, like, the replay, you know, or anything like that. You know,
that's why a lot of boxers, they got to increase the online presence and promote their own fights and cards and do creative shit and just be out there, because, you know, to hype up these smaller shows.
Yeah.
Because you get swallowed up on a full week of boxing.
You do. You know, and funny too, because that card's not even getting a whole lot of attention. Like, I mean, it should be put on a different day where someone would watch. So I would watch this on Friday. I would watch this on Friday, and depending how pissed I am on Sundays about football, I'd probably watch it on Sunday.
Yeah, I'd probably watch it on a Sunday too. I mean, shit, I saw you guys fight on a fucking Sunday.
I mean, yeah, I know, right? Shit. You know, but, yeah, but yeah, you know, like I said, but, you know, obviously it's our duty to at least put it out there. It's like, you know, you have some options to watch for boxing tonight, but we basically, Baranchuk versus Zepeda is the best fight for this coming weekend.
That's yeah, you got leftovers, and you got the Saturday special, and then you got the Wednesday, you know, experimental. You know, I don't know how Mexican pizza is going to taste at the middle school, so let's put it on a Wednesday. So that's how that shit looking right now. But you know, if you a boxing fan, you'll try to watch everything. If not, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, you know, this is as long as you support boxing on the end, so it's all good. You know. So yeah, you know, that takes us to the end of our show for tonight. You know, let's say it was a good show. You know, get a little preview in there, and obviously, you know, next time, hopefully, you know, we'll get, you know, get Rome on here and we do our retro review.
we're shout out to Rome, yielding it down. Yes, can't be with us today.
So P, your final thoughts, bro?
You already know what it is. Ring Game Radio all day, every day. Follow us on ringgameradio.com. You know, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. Fuck us. Got the cartoon episode 2 out. Episode 1, if you've been sleeping. You already know what it is.
That's what it is, man. LLB, man, you got any final thoughts?
Man, what that nigga said, you know what it is. Gang, gang, gang. Ringgangradio.com. Y'all definitely stop sleeping on the cartoon. Episode 2 is amazing. If you're not following my man, Prolific Genius 1, you know, holla at him. You know, follow him on Ring Gang TV, you know, on Instagram, all that shit. Cause, you know, he posted a little clips, you know, King P doing the uppercut, you know, cause it's uppercut season right now.
Exactly.
So, you know,
the uppercut is back.
You know, yeah, the uppercut is back. You know, if the uppercut's back, then, you know, Ring Gang, you know, we definitely throwing uppercuts in this bitch. So, you know, you got, if you follow, you know, Ring Gang, yeah, follow the individual channels and you'll see, you know, all of our talents on another scale. You know what I mean?
Right. And even our human side, you know.
yeah, because we human, you know what I mean? We real people and shit, you know. I know some people, like they don't show their faces, but I mean, if you're one of the Podomatic people, then you could probably say that. But if you subscribe to the YouTube, you know, we got an intro. You know, it's not just music playing, you know, on Podomatic. You know,
yeah, you know,
there's actual video of us. Like, you see us. You know, we're not hiding our faces. It's just, you know, we just on that steez right now. You know,
exactly.
So make sure y'all, you know, y'all just keep tuning in. Get them subscribers up, you know, y'all share, retweet, like, comment, all that shit. You know, we're gonna be just keep giving you, you know, shit. You know, we know who's fucking with us is real 100% fans, you know, fans of the sport boxing. Word. We on some real shit. It's Renaissance. We ain't buying no fucking followers and no fake accounts, none of that shit. Right. It's authentic, real niggas fuck with us. So, you know, yeah. Boxing, you know, ringgangradio.com. That's it. That's all. Past, present, future. The Omega, the Alpha, all of that shit, nigga.
Yeah, man. And who can follow after that? I can't follow after that, man. So, yeah, you know, co-sign what the two brothers are talking about. You know what I'm saying? Ring Gang is the future. Ring Gang is the squad. Ring Gang, it is everything. You know, it's the shit that you want and need in your lives. Can you dig it? So, you know, for myself, you know, the past Gopher, the New England representer, you know, for LB, Shutter with the God, the good artist, you know, for King P, Bodega P, you know, it's been another wonderful episode of Real Talk, where, as always, shit's real, we talk about it. So, until next time, peace.